Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. If you're wondering, like, why are you doing a voiceover? It's y'all, listen, I recorded this video on my iPhone, and when I uploaded the video, almost everything was gone. So I had to do like little clips like this with my actual camera because I was too scared to use my iPhone again, to be honest with you, because you know, you already lost my original clip. Why would I trust you? So I had to use that camera. So you're going to see a few disparity in scaling and possibly quality because of the two cameras that were used. Okay. Yeah. I just kind of felt like I had to do a quick disclaimer to let y'all know. That's why I'm doing like clip fillers like those and voiceovers in certain parts. Okay. Let's get into it.
This wig is from XRS Beauty. It is a beautiful 18-inch wig. And it's absolutely gorgeous. As you can see, it's on my head, right? So when you open up the box, there is a comb that comes with it. Of course, I already used the comb. And there's also several flexi rods that you can style your hair with. Now, with wigs, what I've noticed is that you don't want to put a lot of heat on them. So the flexi rods, like, included is a bop, okay? Just off-rip. It's very thoughtful. It also had like a couple stocking caps that came with it. It's in dark brown, which I loved that they sent me dark brown because I was going to use like a light brown lace. Well, not lace, but stocking cap. And the dark brown just does something to the wig. You know, it hits different. The wig also came with an elastic band that I threw away because, you know, I don't like elastic bands. I don't like it. And one thing I like about this wig is that when you lift it up, you can't really see your kitchen.
All right, this part is for all my girls with the full edges out there. Now, if you're trying to keep your edges, I suggest you gel them down when you're doing a wig install. If you already bald, you ain't got nothing to lose, baby. Go ahead and glue that wig on that scalp. You feel me? YOLO. But if you're trying to keep your edges, glue it down with some type of oil-free gel, like the Gustavi glue gel that I'm using right now. I'm using the one in the black bottle because, one, it's all I had, and two, it's less flaky than the yellow one, in my opinion. But go ahead and protect them bad boys, because when you do your wig removal, your edges are going to be intact. This is the stocking cap that came with the wig, y'all. I'm in love with this stocking cap, and I am gonna buy a whole bunch more in that same color because I have been so conditioned to think that, you know, I should use like a lighter stocking cap because that's all I see on YouTube. You know, everybody want to use a lighter stocking cap. So I kind of figured like, oh, maybe the darker stocking cap would make my lace too dark, and I want my lace to be natural, so I'm gonna gravitate toward the lighter stocking cap. I was so wrong. Like, I would say whatever stocking cap matches your skin tone or is in that skin tone range is the stocking cap you should use, to be honest with you. Now, if you're white, I always wanted to say white. Now, if you're white or you're super light skin, I would suggest you go with a lighter stocking cap because obviously that's within your range. You know, it'll look most natural on your head. But if you're like my complexion, darker, or maybe even a little bit lighter, you can definitely get away with the darker stocking cap. Period, poo. So, the reason why I cut holes in the ears is because it creates tension on the temple. If you're having a lot of problems with your wig lifting at the edges, like on the sideburn areas, this method will eliminate that problem. So, oh, you guys don't do this. Do not do this. All right. You see how I'm putting the glue on my edges like that? Do not smear this glue. I'll show you what type of glue I'm using right now, like in a few. I think it's the Bold Hold one. I'm not really sure though. I forgot. But do not smear it. I did this twice and I smeared it twice. Okay. That thing is gonna show very white on your lace. And you don't want white lace. You want natural lace. You don't want shiny lace. You want natural skin-like lace. And this is exactly what it's gonna do because it's gonna dry white instead of clear, like it's supposed to. So what you want to do, there you go. I can't read that. Y'all can read that, right? So you want to dot on your hairline area, or like mark or map out the spots that you want to put your lace on, and you just want to dot it. You don't want to smear it, at least not while it's wet. All right, and then when it's dry, it's gonna dry clear. Now we're at one of my most favorite parts in this entire process, is actually plopping that damn wig on my head, because I'm like, yes, thank you, Lord. I don't look like no naked mole rat no more. I look like I actually have hair growing from my scalp, except it tried me, right? Y'all see that white on the side of my, well, y'all can't see it now, but I'm pretty sure y'all saw the white glue on the side, and also the top is shiny. Excuse me, we gonna have to fix that. Okay, because one thing you're not gonna do, glue, is embarrass me out in public. First of all, I want people to look at my head and think that's my real hair. Think that's scalp that they're looking at. If they see white, you know, and shine, they gonna know it's a wig. The whole purpose of wearing a wig is to make it look natural. Okay, so that's why I removed it, and I don't think I have that clip, but I actually went back over it with just Gots to Be Glued spray to hold it down instead, because I always find like that works best for me. And these glues, and you know, they're like, you have to dot instead of smear. It's just too much. So right now all I'm doing is just cutting the lace, and you want to be very careful when you're cutting the lace, because you don't want to cut too much and make a mistake and can't fix it. So you always want to cut a little bit at a time. Like you see, I have a lot of lace left, and I'm just going to go back over that to like give it a little bit of a fine tune. Y'all, please do not skip this step. This step is extremely important for a natural looking hairline. Now you can do everything else, but if you have a straight ass hairline, that is not going to look realistic. You're gonna look wiggy. So you want to zigzag your scissors or your blade across the hairline, or else you're gonna be looking like this. And I don't know who did that to Elena and Terrence, because I'm a big fan of the Vampire Diaries and Empire. And when I saw those episodes, yo, the way I laughed. Anyway, child, the next clip, I lost the previous clip too. So like, if I just jump right into it, you guys will probably be lost. And I really like the clip because it leads into the other one, and I think it's pretty funny. Anyway, I'm just being indecisive as Leo, as usual. Nothing to see here, but hope you guys enjoy.
I'm not gonna change into my outfit anymore because it's only 4 o'clock, you know, and I don't want to be in the same outfit all day. You know, but I do want to take some pictures. You know when you look cute and you just want to show everybody, like, hey, I look cute today. But that's how I feel. But I don't know if I want to. I'll be back. Okay, she's back. She's back, folks. Ladies and gentlemen, her. So this is my outfit. Y'all could see like the little panty line, but don't worry about that because it ain't gonna be there tonight. This is my mother freaking outfit for tonight. Bitch. So I'm feeling myself, obviously, and I feel like my makeup is freaking bomb. Go get the shit, and go get the shit, okay? Like, my makeup has not looked this good in so long, and it's because of the foundation. Like, this foundation is beautiful. But okay, that's it. I'm about to take some pictures and get ready to go shake my little ass in somebody's club. This is coming off like I'm not gonna wear this, but yeah, I'm talking too much because I look cute. I look cute.
The reason why I got this wig is because Arnell Armon did a video on it and it looked so bomb on her, but she's like a freaking wig goddess anyway. So, but I feel like I did a really good job on this wig. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. Let me know what you think of this chopped and screwed type of video in the comment section below, because y'all, I tried. Okay, I tried. But that's it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed. And I love y'all. And y'all be safe, okay? I love you. Bye.